My name is Pierre Sully, Boston, Mass. I was former coach at Lesley University, former basketball player at Franklin Pierce University, also former basketball player at Roxbury Community College. Was an All-American there at Roxbury Community College, regional player of the year, first team, all-state, all-region. Played professionally in England, in the English Basketball League for a few, came back. Played in the ABA PBO for the Manchester Mill Rats for a few. What qualifies me to be, you know, why would I want you to train with me? You know, one thing I always do, I pay attention to details a lot when it comes to basketball.
My name is Pierre Sully. And I'm from Jamaica Plain. I started off ATF in 2016. Just as a way for me to be able to, you know, get back and continue my lessons in training, coaching, should I say. I've been fortunate enough to work with some talented players throughout the year, internationally and domestic as well. Been blessed to blessed to work with some great universities, some great colleges, and some great organizations along my path. Been with the Emmanuel College Saints, also coached with the Boston Celtics, Maine Celtics as well. And from there, I decided to just do my own private training and to continue that.
Before the guys get here, I try to just get my little time in, 10 minutes, whatever it is, to myself, the turf, depending on the day. Because of this, you know, I had to modify a lot of the things, but normally I try to get about 20 minutes of film prep before the guys come in, just ideas of how I want to work with them today and things like that. So everything is basically planned for them. You don't really just come in and just get the work in. You come in and make sure the work makes sense. Bruce, Sanse, and Amani come in. So we have three guys that can handle the ball, do different things. So try to create scenarios where they're playing in their spots, not really just out here just to be out here. So with Bruce, his focus for Bruce is just gonna be getting back into playing, being on the ball. Last few years in Brooklyn, and kind of been like the Swiss Army knife. You know, pick and pop, forward for them, sometimes a five. Hasn't really got a chance to display his full ability, but, you know, he's put himself in a very good category from a versatile guy. So, like I said, the plan is to kind of get back to the things that, you know, he was doing in Detroit. Focus on those things while we're here this week. So, like I said, for me, the main thing is trying to get put him in spots where he's comfortable and put him in spots where he feels more natural for him.
Wake up, new bags, I'm working with flavors. She's sucking my shit out the wake up. I tell her she's tasting the flavor. Yeah. Nigga, wake up. new plays, I'm getting this cake up. New days, still chasing the paper. You brave if you try to take some, huh? Wake up, I'm rolling a split for the haters. The first of the month, I took two out the trunk. That's how I'm starting my day up, huh? Nigga, wake up, I take out the scale and the razor. I'm bagging the Addies, I'm bagging the Perkies, I'm bagging whatever you pay for. Nigga, wake up. Mama been working, she praying up. And I'ma go get it however till she living better. She want to wake up. Nigga, she want to wake up. Wake up.
Stop it. talking L, baby.
Humpty.
I'm trying to cop the Benz on my own shit. Sipping DiSerrano with a cold bitch. My new bitch fuck me like she own a dick. She own the shit, I'm just on the shit.
We're snaking. Right here, we're gonna rap. Going live dribble, cross. Here, swing. In and out, swing. In and out, swing. Left hand, left. You guys are going right hand, left, okay? Live dribble, snake, in and out, swing.
Yeah. Smoking out the V, I had to light that shit. Said that I would quit, I had to light that shit. Had to grab the pack, I'll be right back quick. I know you see my style, know you like that shit. Yeah. My mama said I need the blood of Jesus. I got the gold chain with the blood of Jesus. That's a little something for you non-believers. I ain't fucking with you, not my niggas neither. Nah, who said I had to follow rules? Youngins getting killed and they don't make the news. I'm just singing inner city blues. You bout to get your cake, I'ma get it too. And if I don't get my cake, I'ma take your food. Plug gave me one and I made it two. Yeah. Just a young nigga trying to make it through. She taking clothes off and telling naked truth.
I got that word, know you want that shit.
I think I got her right to talk my shit. You know them hoes, man, they stalk my shit. We about to get this money, you can't stop that shit.
Helped me a lot being a coach and also understanding the development of the players and understanding the game. Right now, I've been fortunate enough since started to be able to have my own space and, you know, to be able to continue these teachings, continue these lessons.
Yeah, I got that word, know you want that shit. I think I got it right to talk my shit. You know them hoes, man, they stalk my shit. Got to get this money, you can't stop that shit.
There's a flip side to that coin. What if you do got me boxed in?
You know, in my path, you know, I slide. Has been a great place for me to be able to continue these lessons. Emmanuel College, obviously, where I coached at, Roxbury Community College, where I played at, has been, you know, they've accepted me with open arms. And the Dana Barrows Basketball Club has been a place of a location that's also helped me out in my transition and to my own space located in Easton. And I think for me, the goal was to be able to have a space where I could call my own, but most importantly, be able to have a space where I could create opportunities for other athletes.
Jealousy back, I paint big jerseys, flipping words.
Well, I mean, I just want to keep everything I'm doing now, keep it sharp. Definitely keep my shot consistent, keep the handle tight, and then probably put on a couple more pounds. I'm out here for like a week and a half left, so maybe like a pound or two, add that on, that'll be great for the frame. That's about it, yeah, just keeping everything sharp, everything I've been working on, work on the same thing, and continue to get better.
Able to learn from my athletes. I think the biggest thing that I take away from any time I'm in the gym is I want to learn something from somebody. It's not always me dominating the workout for an hour telling them what to do. It's about learning the people that I'm training. And I think it's important that, you know, it is a team concept between me and the athlete.
More force, if it's going to help you get more forward, as long as you can land. 12 each side. Hold it. Hold. Always hold the end range for at least 2 seconds. Always hold the end range for at least 2 seconds. Good. 12 each side, and we're going to go lateral right after this. Just try to pull that knee away from the body. You'll feel it right here. Okay? Get a big squeeze.
Opportunity. Never thought this would be something that I would do as far as, you know, running a facility, but, you know, as the training has gotten better and more, I think it's being able to allow me to be able to expand and, you know, maybe expand into my own space and my own growth. And also, once again, is to create opportunities for other coaches, other trainers, people that inspire, and other organizations, and also be a staple in the community. It's important.